Hey, Freedom. It's the beginning of Passion Week, and I'm so glad you've joined me on this Monday for the first of our video devotionals. Now, yesterday was Palm Sunday, and we looked at this incredible story of Jesus when he rode into Jerusalem on a colt, celebrated as the king he is. One thing we mentioned was that this event hinged on this big feast for the Israelites, the Feast of Passover. It was a key moment when they celebrated one of the greatest deliverances God had ever brought. Now see, we read about this story in Exodus 12, and we're told clearly that every single family was to go out and find an unblemished male lamb, bring it into the household, and they were supposed to let it be there for 4 days, where their hearts would be endeared to it, this lamb in that time. Then at the end of those 4 days, they take that lamb and they slaughter it. And then it's clear what was supposed to happen next. They take the blood and they put it on the doorposts, the sides, and then the top of the door frame. Now, I want you to think about this. The blood covered the entire door. That meant that you couldn't go in or out of the home without entering through the blood. But also, their very actions, they were prophetic. It went up and down, side to side. It was the action of a cross. How prophetic. But another thing that catches me is that the blood was applied for the family, the household. However, every single individual had to make the choice to enter into the home and to stay in the home. Now, why did God do all this? Well, it's really very clear. He tells us in verse 12 of Exodus 12, "On that same night, I will pass through Egypt, and I will strike down every firstborn of both people and animals, and I will bring judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I am the Lord." See, that was the purpose, is to bring judgment on false gods. False gods can never save. And then he made that declaration, "For I am the Lord, I am Yahweh, I alone am all powerful." And then he says, "And the blood will be a sign for you on the houses where you are, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you." What an incredible moment for these Israelites. But it's all prophetic, because it pointed forward to a far greater deliverance. See, in 1 Corinthians 11, we're told this. On the night when Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, he broke it, he gave thanks, and gave it to his disciples and said, "This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Then he took the cup and he gives it to his disciples and he said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this in remembrance of me." See, all those lambs offered, countless lambs offered year after year, they were temporary covering and they were old covenant. But Jesus, with his blood, he began a brand new covenant. Anyone who enters through his blood is covered once and for all. And I want you to think about all that the blood of Jesus does for you. First of all, his blood is payment for you. As he took his own blood, he entered into the courtroom of heaven and looked at the debt of your sin and with his own blood marked it paid in full. But then not only that, his blood is your adoption price. The Father gave the blood of his one and only Son to be the adoption price, so you are now his son and daughter. So it's payment, but also it's purification. Because his blood takes that ugly, sin-stained heart of ours and it washes it, makes it white as snow. That's how you now appear before God the Father. But then also his blood redeems. It says, "By his stripes we are healed." By his blood we are healed. Is every aspect of your life is redeemed by his blood. Your spirit, your soul, your mind, your emotion, your physical body, your past, your present, your future, everything redeemed. And then finally, ultimately, you're marked by his blood. Just like the Israelites marked their door frames, you're marked. The most precious commodity this world has ever known, the blood of Jesus, marks you and says, "I am his." What a great way to celebrate. And I tell you, this week, let's take time and pause and just thank God for all that the blood of Jesus does for us. And one more thing. One thing a lot of families are doing, taking red ribbon, and just as a simple symbolic act, putting it on the door frames outside their homes. And this is a declaration just saying, this home trusts in God. This home looks to God to save us through all times, all seasons, but especially in this season of crisis. So if you want to join us, then find red ribbon and just put it on your door frame, your mailbox, wherever. Or if you don't have any, We're going to have a red ribbon patrol, and all you have to do is email us or message us, and we will come by your house and we will put it wherever you tell us to put it. We don't even have to have any physical interaction. But what a great way for us, the Freedom Family, to be unified all throughout our community and unified with other believers who are also doing this. So if you want the red ribbon, just let us know. Okay, let's close in prayer. Jesus, how could we ever say thank you enough? Thank you, Jesus, for that you, the King of this universe, would see us worthy enough to come and shed your blood for us. We can't thank you enough. And God, may we be changed by it. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.